Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. How would Freya agree to marry Odin?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
I can read what this says now, but it's a name.
Gerdrifol.
Whoa! The name made it light up.
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother, the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves. Or I can just tell you this story later.
I didn't think anything could get through all that hell bramble.
These bones pulse with magic.
It must be Gullveig. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
This spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
So you were saying Thor is half god and half giant? That's so weird.
Aye. But Odin and Fjordun's love was true. Once Fjordun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, they agreed. But I can just tell you the story later.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Treasure map. All right. Gulvig's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Gulvig?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined. A thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake. I know not what I did to anger Thor. Boy. His judgment was swift and brutal.
Boy, what a sad story.
Yes. We should help him.
Really?
You are surprised.
Well, yeah. I didn't think you'd care about helping a spirit.
Fighting more Hellwalkers is good experience for you.
Oh. So what was it like when Odin and Freya got married?
For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would later bitterly regret. Or I can just tell you the story later.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Hey, it's another treasure map. For more like this.
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. Never mind. I just gotta return the bones.
Maybe I can fly.
No, no! Gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
Look, don't be mad, but I've seen those blades of yours before. They were under the house when I was hiding. Is that why you never let me down there? Where did they come from?
They are my burden, from a life that is behind me.
Well, they're in my life too now, and I'd like to hear that story.
Those days are dead. To relive them is needless.
How can it be needless if it's the truth?
One day, you will understand.
I'll take your word for it.
So Odin and Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, O powerful Gulvig!
Erni bukar birthiast.
She says she'll honor our request.
Erdi fagnar.
And reunite us?
In
okay, you are
okay, brother.
say it. I told you so.
I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin... his madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Thank you.
come and face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my father built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. First we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunk rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well.
What do you think, Mimir? What does Baldur want with us?
Well, let's look at what we know. Baldur is Odin's finest tracker, bar none. If he wants you, you have to consider the possibility that Odin wants you. And as for what Odin wants, on this I have some expertise.
What could we have that Odin doesn't? He's like the
king of gods. Of the Aesir, aye. But his reach is not unlimited. And where he cannot reach, he is preoccupied with going. He certainly tortured me enough about it over the years.
Spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Thank you.
you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Something down there. Mimir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, when victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr.
What?
I'll tell this one later.
Part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
Kvikja! Well, worth a shot.
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it. He would.
Down there. So what happened when Tyr brought Odin to Jotunheim?
Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word and his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Another shipwreck under the water. We could beach the boat here.
Come on!
Boy.
Sir. Okay. That's going in the journal. Father, were you ever a leader?
Many years ago, yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you ever...
No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir. Question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ginnungagap, the Great Void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced...
Water?
Water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that he had. Tell us when they meet.
Satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why did he do this?
Look here.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great. Father, why did you really want to help the spirit?
You need the experience.
I've had plenty of experience fighting these things. What's the real reason?
This man inspired loyalty. He took responsibility for his mistakes, and he was determined to fix them. These are good lessons for you.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
Come here. Can you finish that story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we?
Oh.
Ymir, the first giant, had emerged from the void, and every form of life began to spring forth from Ymir. Well, I can just tell you the story later.
My men are...
That's right. We kill... We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life, you were honorable, strong-willed, and you inspired loyalty. These are good qualities, aren't they, boy?
Yeah. I couldn't believe how many men followed you here.
I thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end than mine.
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
Can you finish that story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we?
Oh.
Ymir, the first giant, had emerged from the void, and every form of life began to spring forth from Ymir.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came. First from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. Well, I can just tell you the story later.
I know I saw something.
I saw it too.
Freya did say the Jotunheim Realm Tower was missing from the lake. But maybe only kinda?
Very strange indeed.
You want a beach here?
Thank you.
before anything else happens. How's that story?
Odin's spear had spilled the lifeblood of Ymir, the first giant. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator, and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant!
Ymir?
Huh? Oh. Sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
What's that down there? We found something.
Armor piece? Oh, I hope it's a new armor piece. Ah, offerings to Tyr. These are quite rare, you know.
Why?
Well, you know Odin, not the biggest fan of Tyr. I thought he destroyed all of these. Let's do it.
In the fine details. Yeah.
try keeping that clean.
I think that's a keeper. Yes, dear boy?
Far from the least. Ooh, what more do you need? Happy to provide.
I still can't believe a son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, we only got one side of the story. But come on, his own father? I mean, I get angry at you sometimes, but...
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I'd never stab you in the back.
No. I imagine not.
This clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water wheel.
My thought as well.
Be ready!
What's that?
Careful!
When are you angry?
What?
With me. When?
Oh, I guess sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can.
It is not always easy to know what.
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that whetstone I wanted? What happened over there?
This is the sun.
That ghost sun? How do you know?
The sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's back. He stood his ground, but it was not enough.
They betrayed him.
Betrayal begets betrayal. My guess, the young one murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others.
He thought himself ready to lead. It cost him his life.
I guess.
Look there, lad. By his feet.
The whetstone!
Yes. They used it to smash his face in.
They did? Ew. Sindri wants it. It must be really useful.
Well, lad, reavers have very specific priorities. If it's not shiny and you can't eat or drink it, might as well use it as a blunt object.
Move up!
Look here.
Yes, sir. There's a scroll here. It belonged to the sun. Wow, this goes on and on. Father, forgive me. Filled with remorse. Forget my actions.
Had he thought before taking action, there would be no need for regret, yes?
Yeah. Maybe we should bring this to his father, back at the storeroom. There sure is a lot to see here. Something down there. Hey, we can dodge him.
You didn't happen to find the whetstone, perchance?
We found your whetstone.
Oh, wonderful! This staining is unusual.
The Reavers used it to smash another Reaver's face in.
Oh, wonderful. Here, for your trouble. I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look like much, but it's practically humming with magic. I've needed a new one after my brother borrowed the last one. I saw him spit on it.
To lube it up!
He said. I didn't ask for it back.
How about you, young one? I think you'll be pleased, young man. What shall it be? Was there more to discuss?
Wants to go where he can't reach. Are you saying he's trying to get to Jotunheim too?
Aye. It ranks among his foremost obsessions.
But that doesn't make any sense, Mimir.
Oh? When did I stop making sense?
You're saying Baldur tracked us down to find the way to Jotunheim. But that was before we knew Jotunheim is where we needed to go. That's crazy.
Except for one thing. You are headed for Jotunheim, so he was right.
I'm so confused.
Well then, clearly you've been listening.